A dynamic effect is made up of math functions placed on a base point on a parameter. For example, a circle effect consists of two sine waves, one on pan, one on tilt, with one of the waves offset a little from the other. There are many dynamic effect templates or shapes defined in the software. These effects are usually best where you need smooth movement of pan and tilt or other parameters, or where it doesn't really matter which colors get created or where a fixture ends up during its movement. If you need to hit specific positions or colors, a content effect is probably a better choice. A dynamic effect playback can play one shape or template at a time, and it will snap from one shape to the next without leaving any leftover shape data on the channels that are running the effect. You can completely configure a dynamic effect playback blind by keeping the playback intensity at zero while you set up your effect. When you raise the intensity, you'll bring up a nice, clean, running dynamic effect. So let's build one. I have one already inserted, but if I wanted to make a new one, I can say insert effect. In this case, I type the number 11 and then hit insert effect to get a specific number. This is just for organizational control in my show. I'm going to pick the dynamic effect tab, and you can see there's no wizard associated with this because everything about the dynamic effect will be set up on the playback itself. I'll hit execute. We can see that effect playback's been inserted and it's already selected, and I have all of the parameters for that dynamic already on my device controls dock. In this case, we're gonna set up some kind of, circle effect. So I'm gonna pick these lights and home them, get rid of any gobos and colors and stuff in them, keep it simple, so there we are. And I'm going to point them at a focus palette I've already made called piano. So now these lights, these spots are pointing at the piano. I'm going to type 11 effect or effect 11 dot dot to select that playback and now set up how my circle effect is supposed to work. My channel source can either be a channel set or a group. A channel set is described in another tutorial. Groups are just the groups that we've recorded for channel selection for other parts of my show. So I'm going to pick groups. I want group 13. And I could tap and find group 13 in this film strip list if I wanted. Or I can type 13 on my keypad and hit that parameter. And it's going to go directly to group 13. My dynamic template, again, is going to be a film strip list of all the possible shapes you have in the software that are already built up. I want to use a circle, so I'll pick that one. And then the next three parameters are the offset relationship. Are the lights going to move together as one, or are they going to follow each other around the piano? Or are you going to set up groupings within the selection? Odds, evens, thirds, fourths, etc. We'll leave that as evenly spread for now. The delay relation and distance allows me to set up turn-taking. So with a delay relationship of all, it means there is no delay. All the lights are going to be moving in this circle at the same time. I can set up again in these groupings or evenly spread that one light will go through the circle, then the next light will go through the circle, then the next light, and so on, or halves, thirds, fourths, etc. One half will complete the circle, then the next one will complete the circle. I'm going to leave this at all for now. And then I'll show you that live when we get this thing running. Rate and size then are how fast are the lights going to move through the circle and how big is the circle going to be. As I bring up the intensity on effect 11, you'll see the circle gets bigger. And when I'm at full intensity, right now, I'm getting a size of as big as possible. And you can see the lights are going up into the rig and out into the audience. Maybe I want this circle to stay tight to the piano. So I'm going to pick a new number, 20%, let's say, and hit the size parameter. And now you can see when my effect playback is at full, that's as big as my circle will get. If that's not big enough, I can expand it. So let's say maybe 50%, because maybe sometimes I want to make a big circle and sometimes I want to make a small circle. What's nice about this setup is that the intensity of this dynamic effect playback is mapped to the size parameter. So now I can scale very simply from that 50% size to stopped and anywhere in between. So I have a very small circle or my biggest possible circle in this design, which is really a 50% value on size. So you don't have to write a big circle, medium circle, and small circle. You can just scale the intensity of the dynamic playback and make that different size circle as needed. Those are the basics of getting your dynamic effect going. So I said I was going to mention delay relationship. And what we'll do is we'll set this to evenly spread. And what that lets me do now is determine how much of the circle is going to be completed before the next light starts. So right now I've got it set to 50%, which means one light gets halfway through the circle before the next light starts. So you can always see two lights in motion. You can keep playing with this until you're happy with how the distribution is going. Once you've got all your settings made and you're happy with the way that this thing looks, make sure to record it somewhere. You can record it into a preset on the main playback. You can record it into a preset on the masters. You could record a palette of the all palette type for as many of these parameters as you want to gang together and recall quickly. But once you get that effect looking the way you want, it's very important to record it somewhere so that it gets stored in your show file and you can recall it or play it back again in the exact same way later on. If you don't record it, the next time you start your show file, that effect playback, just like any moving lights in your show, will start up again in the home position, which may not be the best looking effect. So record your effect playbacks and all will be well. And these are dynamics.